So I was just back in the woods trying to bush hog some saplings and video that for you when what I believe happened is I drove over a sapling and instead of it going under my wheel or off to the side a little bit, it came right down the middle and grabbed this collar, this sleeve on the drive shaft. And when it did that, it yanked my drive shaft right off the PTO. And now I can't get my PTO back on. Now, a confession, when I first got the tractor and I was simply changing the implements out, I had a problem where I couldn't get the shaft back on. When I broke down and read the manual and found out that my problem was is that there's a collar on this. There's a collar that you're supposed to push forward that releases three bearings on the inside of this collar so that you can slip it on your PTO. On your PTO, there's not only grooves going horizontal, but there's also a groove that's perpendicular to that that those bearings catch on. But to get to that groove, you have to release the bearings to slide it on, and then it'll snag and keep your drive shaft on your PTO. Well, it's not working this time. I just cannot seem to get that collar to release the bearings so that I can slide it in. So I called up the tractor shop and they told me that sometimes the bearings, in the kind of situation I explained to them what I thought happened, sometimes the bearings can, I guess the spring mechanism or whatever is on the inside that helps them retract and expand's not the right word, but for lack of a better one. Sometimes it can get off kilter or a piece of dirt can get in there and you just gotta get them back on track. You gotta pop them, you know, one can get stuck, I guess is basically the best way to say it. So their suggestion was to try to put a screwdriver down in there and see if I can get the bearings to release so that I can slide it back onto my shaft. And then if not, they said I need to bring in this front half of the drive shaft and they can replace this collar mechanism. So since I just spent $5 repairing the pin for my top link, I really don't want to have to take it in there because I'm pretty sure that's going to run me a bit more than $5. So I'm going to tinker with it and let you guys know how it goes. I just want you guys to know how much I think of you. So I'm still going to put this on YouTube rather than delete the videos and act like it never happened. This is the front half of the drive shaft for my bush hog. And this little slip collar here is what I was trying to adjust so that I could slip back on. I know you won't be able to see this, but maybe with the light you can see the grooves. And down in three of those grooves are the ball bearings. Now here's what I was trying to do. I was sliding this forward. When I do that, I can feel a spring pressure, and it seems to me it gives you the feeling like that's what you're supposed to do to release those ball bearings. Well, after about a half hour of frustration, phone call to the tractor company, and another few minutes of frustration, taking this thing completely off of the bush hog, which actually wasn't as difficult as I thought it was going to be, I realize that a spring, wait for it, has two sides. And that maybe the other side's not solid. Maybe you can push on the other side. So I spent about a half hour pushing this forward, using a screwdriver to try to adjust these bearings and make them pop back into place, just like I was told. And then I discovered I can do this. You see, the front half of this comes back, and that releases the bearings. So I'm gonna put this back together, I'm gonna slide this PTO back on, and I'm gonna get back to work. But just in case somebody else out there ever has this problem, don't try adjusting this collar from the back. Adjust it from the front. Okay, so what I was trying to do is push this collar forward. So you can see when I push it forward and I try to slide it on, nothing was happening. But now if I pull this collar back, it went on just like it's showing. Well, 1 hour of learning for a lifelong knowledge, I guess, is worth it. Let's get going.